kind of like my uniform for filming. I really love roll neck tops, so yeah. On today's episode, I'm going to be answering questions from the Secret Life of a YouTuber tag. The tag I saw in the Ubani's channel, and I thought it would be nice to do it so some of you get to know my YouTube journey a bit better. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Stephanie and I'm a London-based Nigerian content creator. I film videos on fashion and lifestyle, which includes travel, food, etc. I'm going to be answering 12 simple questions on my journey as a YouTuber. I don't know who formed this tag, but let's get right into this. How long have you been on YouTube? So guys, my journey on this particular channel started in 2018. First of all, I joined YouTube, let's say 2015-16. And I was, you know, doing videos on and stuff. I'll probably put a little picture of my thumbnails from that particular video because I had an app then and I just found a screenshot of it. So yeah, then I used to feature people and we just talk about lifestyle things that affected people my age. And then it was Show Big Brother is a show I'm really, really obsessed with. So guys, I said putting content on Big Brother for fellow people who didn't stay in Nigeria but really love the show. So I was just like analyzing, reviewing, just talking day to day on things that were happening in the Big Brother house. And then one time I just got a strike from YouTube. Obviously it was handled by MultiChoice because of the content I put. I think I put some videos that like got like 120k views. And once you start getting unnecessary views like that on it, content that is not yours, the owner first of all gets angry, they report to YouTube. YouTube will get angry too and give you a strike. Guys, on YouTube, when you get 3 strikes, your channel is just in trouble because you literally have to go and appeal, call the people who gave you the strike. It's just a very long process. So yeah, I got that 1 strike and then I hit some of my videos. Then again, got careless and just kept posting. You know when people are just following you up and down, you're watching your videos, you're just so excited. Before I knew, like 2 strikes came or 3 strikes just came back to back to back, and then my channel was in trouble. So I said trying to see if I could do the appeal process, but it was just long. I think YouTube gave me like 30 or 60 days come back and, you know, appeal and follow the process. So I just said, whatever, I closed it down. So I just chilled till, yeah, it was 2018, and then immediately I opened another channel. Yes, with my other email, because I actually thought you could have, but you could. So I put on that channel and I used the same Big Brother to get my 10k, 1k views and the 4 hours of watch time, you know, on that channel. But monetization still took a while, so the whole Big Brother thing ended, blah, blah, blah. Next year, which was last year, I, you know, grew a lot of Big Brother. So to be very honest, Big Brother was actually one show that actually gave me the subscribers I have. So yeah, there's no other magical. At what point do you think you would stop? I don't think I would stop at any point right now that I know of, because I still enjoy creating content. I love just thinking about things and putting them. The reason I started my YouTube channel in the first place was like an extension of my fashion blog, MetroGypsy.org. So I just thought YouTube would be a better voice for people to just listen, because people don't like clicking into blogs and reading. I think it's just easy to listen to a video and doing other things. That's another thing you can do with my videos. If you're not in the mood to sit down one page, just play my videos and be doing other things in your house. Just increase the volume and you enjoy it. So yeah, I don't intend stopping anytime soon. What's the best thing about YouTube? I think the best thing about YouTube is planning the content and then actually filming it, editing. Oh gosh, I love editing. Though I don't edit that deeply anymore. I used to edit with my laptop before, now I edit with my phone. Once my laptop crashed one time, I got used to the phone, and since then, guys, I don't need to look back. So I'm always editing on my phone. I rarely edit on my laptop. It's crazy how addicted I was to editing on my laptop then. Now I don't even care about it. So I think I just love editing and just bringing a thought process into fruition and stuff. The worst thing about YouTube, guys, is the views and subscribers just being nice and stuff. It's just hard. Growing on YouTube is really, really tough. Like, I have 8k subscribers now, guys, because of people that I know. It's not even anything I'm doing, but then again, it's something I enjoy. I just really enjoy like creating content in the way I love to. I think I really love branding and aspects of branding. Growth is really, really, really slow. Sure. How many thumbnail options do you usually take? Guys, I don't take that much. I think I would say 3. Thing is, I do a lot of Instagram, so I always have pictures on Instagram, and I don't really care about using the picture I used to film as my thumbnail. Except it's an event I went and I took pictures already. Like, I always have, like, I don't know. But with these sit-down videos, I think you consider that more. Like, when I do haul videos, I already have pictures of the outfits for Instagram, so I just put it on YouTube. So I would say like 2 or 3. Most of the time, what actually stresses me out is what to write on the thumbnail. Just make it catchy or just make it... Yeah, that's where I actually waste time. But if it's for thumbnail options, I usually have a lot. already, so I don't actually take for thumbnail, but with this video I'll probably take with this my turban. Who's your YouTube crush? I will say Maze Lee. I don't know if you know Elena and Joe, the family of 7 kids, or is it 9 kids? I think it's 7. Yeah, I love them, guys. I love them. I love the dedication to their craft, how they just portray the children. The girl has a PhD and she's, you know, running a home like that. Joe, how creative he is. The children, how intelligent they are. Like, look at that baby. The baby after, before the baby. If you know the channel, the baby before, that girl is the smartest girl in the world. And the rest of the girls and boys, like, they all have different talents. They're so outspoken. The way Elena just, I don't know, the way she just runs that family is amazing. Like, those kids are going to be superstars, I swear. So yeah, I think I'll say Elena and Joe. Both of them are my YouTube crush. So their channel, Maze Lee, is my YouTube crush channel. Who's on your collab wish list? I don't know, maybe Kylie Jenner now. Maybe at the time Kylie Jenner would just put me somewhere. I won't be looking for subscribers again. But on a serious note, I think I'll say Moss Oyin. She's just so classy. She really takes her branding very seriously and she knows how to tell a good story. So yeah, that's someone who I would love to do a collaboration with. What are you wearing on your bottom half? Nothing serious. I was actually wearing a dress before this video started and I decided to, sorry, I can't raise it up too much, but so I was wearing a tank dress before I started this video and I just put up this turtleneck because this is kind of like my uniform for filming. I really love roll neck tops, so yeah. How long until you actually click record? Guys, not very long, because once I think, okay, I want to film today, like now my hobby went out and I was like, best time to film now. And I just set up my thing. My stuff is not much. I'm not even using lighting right now. My lighting is here, is off. And I brought my camera, the 55mm one, so that I can scream in the house. Because when he's here, I'm screaming. He'll just be saying I'm screaming. So now he's not here. I'm using this camera. It doesn't zoom. So I'm like really, really far away from the camera. But at least I can shout, because I don't use the mic. So you guys, my setup is not even long at all. I have a G7X, which is my normal vlogging camera. It's also my normal filming camera. And then I have my EOS 70D. With its original lens, which I never used again. I have another lens, which is the 50mm one. I use for like detailed shots for Instagram and products and stuff. And then I have a longer lens, but I wanted to use this one because it blurs out stuff nicely. And yeah, I'm home alone. It doesn't take me, as I came here after tying this, and I just pressed record, sat down here. There was a frame here, I took it down, sat down and started filming. I don't waste time to, the only thing that takes my time, yes, is when I say, hi guys. Blah blah blah, or introducing the video. Oh my gosh, I always just say some rubbish like 5 times before I get the right thing. And yeah, but I try to delete all the rubbish before I start editing so that my editing is not that stressful. But even with this video now, I said a lot of nonsense in the beginning, so the editing is going to be stressful. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Stephanie. And when I do fashion, how do you feel about the YouTube community and culture? The community, I don't know, there's no feelings because I don't really think I'm part of the YouTube community. I don't think there's anybody that really cares about me that much in the YouTube community or any other things. You get, I'm not really a part of the community, to be honest, but I think it's okay. I think there's a lot of mediocrity with people and stuff, but then again, like, you, something might be mediocre to you, but other people like it, other people want to hear about it. You get, so YouTube community as a, like, internationally amazing. Like, content creators are now ruling, like, journalism, so many things. Like, the YouTube space is great. Like, Met Gala, you see YouTubers. Is the community internationally is amazing. But like, community in my own, in fact, I don't even know what community I belong in. I'm Nigerian, not based in Nigeria, and I don't even know who cares about me, to be honest. So I wouldn't say that. Now for the culture, I think it's quite nice. Like, there are people, when you support them, they support you back. There are people that, few people actually give you constructive criticism. Some people just go on your video and put one love smiley. And so there's just a lot of laziness and genuineness. Like, there's a lot of eye service. The culture is somehow, but yeah, I just try to support people who support me. Like, sometimes I'm bored, I just go into my comment section and start just looking at videos of people who drop comments in my last video and things like that, because a lot of people are just here to waste, deceive you, and just, I don't know. So the culture is just porous, you know, see. But yeah, there are people, there are very amazing people who support you, and I really appreciate you guys. Yeah. What's the secret to a successful channel? Like, I'll say consistency and quality videos. which also good content is under quality video. So I think consistency and yeah, just adding value. Whatever you're doing, just think, what value am I adding? It could be humor, it could be just making people chill, because some people just really like love a long story or a funny story. So yeah, and it could be just mentoring people, tutorials. So yeah, I think if you're consistent, that really helps. And then you have a clear visual, something nice for us to watch, and then your content is quite funny. Yeah, and then collaborations. Yeah, your channel will be successful if you collaborate with people who are like minds, or people who you think their followers will like your kind of content as well. Yes, that will help you have a successful channel. But just stay away from copyright stuff, guys. It's so annoying. And who do you tag? So for this video, I think I'm supposed to tag just one person, and I'm going to tag Naomi Shapumba. She's a South African based YouTuber. She does a lot of videos on small and medium enterprises, small business owners, just living, like, you know, a genuine and authentic lifestyle. Yeah, I really love her. So yeah, Naomi, do this tag. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe if you haven't, and then if you're part of my family members who is coming again, I appreciate and love you so much. See you on the next episode. Bye bye.